Hi, I'm Mike. I'm out in my garage doing some home mechanic work. My job today is I gotta put a new rack and pinion in my Trailblazer. That's not what the video is about. The video is about how to realign your wheels on the new rack and pinion to the exact position they were on the old rack and pinion. To do that, I have my vehicle set on jack stands, all four corners, tires off the ground, the vehicle will not move. I also have my workbench in front of me. It will not move. My steering wheel is strapped. It will not move. All right, to start this procedure out, I need to remove the wheel and tire. All right, now I need my rotor so it will not move on the wheel. So I'm going to turn the lug nuts back on so it bolts tight. Snug them down. Two should suffice. All right, my next step, I don't want the A-arms hanging off the suspension. So I'm gonna take a jack underneath. And I'm gonna jack up the A-arm and get a measurement from the floor to the center of the bolt. On this one, 16 inches is the mark I'm picking, and we are at 16 inches. And I'll record that. Once I have the new rack, I'll use that measurement again. Now, I have bought a laser. You can buy these anywhere online. They're very inexpensive. Shoots a crisscross line. You'll see it in just a minute. If you can see on my workbench, you see the laser line shining to my workbench. At this point, I'm going to line this up on here and get an arrow point. I'm just flushing this out on the rotor. I need to mark this at the point I have this mounted on the rotor to where I can see my crisscross, and hold this steady and just mark my rotor where I put the laser jet. Now I need a helper to go up and mark the lines on my bench. Mark a vertical and a horizontal line right at that exact point. Perfect. Now we go over to the other side and do the same thing again. I already have the wheel and tire off. I already have it jacked up to the height we need. It's the exact same thing we did on the other side. The only thing I need to do here is get my laser point on my workbench. This will work on any vehicle with a rack and pinion. And that would conclude this part of the video. The next part will come up once I have the new rack and pinion off. I'll show you how to turn it and line them right back up. Okay, I have the old rack and pinion off, the new one on. We measured the outer tie rods ends compared to the old rack and turned them as close as we could by measuring. Right now I made sure my steering wheel was the same position it was before we started. You can tell I still have the rotor bolted on, and I also have the A-arm jacked up to the height that I predetermined where we were going to shoot our frame. And right now we're ready to see how close we were and adjust it if need be. And you can see we were pretty close by measurement. And now we'll turn the inner tie rod end and pull us back to square. A little bit yet. and stop right there. Perfect. Now we'll repeat that on the other side. I got to move my jack over there. Inches. Now we're ready to line up the laser and adjust the tie rod end. And again, you can see we were pretty close from measuring. Turn it out. Turn it out. Little bit. Little bit. Perfect. At that point, the wheel alignment should be the same exact as it was before we started. Right now we have to do a couple other things. My next part of this video will be once I have it up and running and take a road trip and come back, and we'll finish up at the end of this. I took the vehicle for a test ride. The steering wheel stayed exactly square of where I put it when I started. Drove down the road, the vehicle drives straight, pulled in the garage, the steering wheel's setting straight, the wheels are aligned. I really think that if you are in alignment before you started this project, you will be in alignment now. But if you're unsure of it, by all means, get a professional alignment done. But I think you're so close right now, you're gonna be able to drive your vehicle without any problems. That's the end of this video. I hope it helps somebody out with the same situation I'm in. Again, I believe this will work on any vehicle with a rack and pinion. End of video. Thanks.
Well, I left Kentucky back in 49 and went to Detroit working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry, 'cause I always wanted me one that was long and black. One day I devised myself a plan that should be the envy of most any man. I'd sneak it out of there in a lunchbox in my hand. Now getting caught meant getting fired, but I figured I'd have it all by the time I retired. I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style.